Novel Audio presents The Cabin by Natasha Preston. Read for you by Morag Sims.
Prologue. They think they're invincible. They think they can do and say whatever they want. They think there are no consequences. They've left me no choice. It's time for them to pay for their sins. Chapter 1. Friday, August 7th. Do you have everything you need, Mackenzie? Mum asked, watching me stuff clothes in a bag. I think so. We're only going for 2 nights anyway. 2 painful nights of dealing with Josh.
Remember to leave the address and phone number on the fridge.
I don't think the cabin has a landline, but I'll leave the address. I'll get cell reception out there, apparently, and I'll let you know when we arrive. She nodded nervously and gave me a weak smile.
Mum, I'll be fine. You're spending the weekend with someone you don't like.
No, I'm spending the weekend with Aaron, Courtney, Megan and Kyle. It's just unfortunate that Josh will be there too. If I could have uninvited him, I would have. But the cabin is his parents, so that didn't seem too likely. Or reasonable. He'd invited us all to spend the weekend at his family's cabin since school was out. The UK had finally realised it was summer, and next year we'd all be going our separate ways for university.
If you need to be picked up early...
I shook my head. Thanks, but I'll be fine. There's no way I'm letting him ruin a weekend with my friends. Anyway, I need to go.
I'll drop you off at Joshua's.
No, it's fine, Mum. I can walk. I grabbed my bag and swung it over my shoulder. See you Sunday night. Love you. I said, kissing her cheek.
Love you too, sweetheart. Call if you need anything.
I will, I replied. Josh only lived a 2-minute walk away, so it wouldn't take me long. I slammed the front door behind me and headed down the path. The weather was super hot, it being the beginning of August, and I was glad I'd opted for shorts and a t-shirt. When I got to Josh's, everyone was outside his house, cramming bags into cars. Seriously, we were going for 2 nights, but it looked like Courtney and Megan had packed for a week.
Kens!
Courtney shouted, jogging toward me. Her red ponytail swayed and her green eyes danced with excitement. She was the only person genuinely happy about this trip. Taking a deep breath, I pushed away every ounce of doubt I had about this weekend and smiled.
Hey, Court, is everyone ready? Almost. Josh will be back soon.
She replied with a goofy smile.
Don't look like that,
she added when I grimaced at his name. Oops, she'd caught me. Sorry, I didn't mean that. It's nice of him to invite us to his folks' cabin. She took my lame apology with a smile.
He wants things back the way they were.
Did he have a time machine so he could go back and not say those awful things about my friends? Could he take back what he'd done to me? What he was still doing to me. Josh might be trying to make amends for the past, if we were even to believe it was genuine, but we weren't going to forgive him so easily. Some hurts aren't that easy to get over, and I couldn't forgive someone who wasn't sorry and hadn't changed their behaviour. Courtney had forgiven him already, of course, but she never could see what a waster her boyfriend was. I lifted my eyebrow.
Mackenzie, please.
Courtney said, sighing as she pushed her bangs out of her eyes.
He's trying, and it will mean so much to me if you'll try to. Please.
I groaned and my shoulders sagged. Fine, I'll play nice. 2 nights, that's it. You can do that.
We all will,
Megan added, stepping beside us.
Right, guys?
Aaron and Kyle nodded along, agreeing to put their differences to the side. For the weekend, at least. Where is Josh anyway? I asked.
Picking up his brother? Courtney rolled her eyes. Blake wanted to see him again, so Josh invited him this morning.
Technically, the cabin belongs to Blake too, so there's not much anyone can do to stop him from coming with.
Oh, I muttered, not sure how I felt about a stranger joining us. We didn't know Blake, and if he was anything like Josh, the weekend was going to be a nightmare. So the estranged brother is coming. Great. This trip keeps getting better and better.
I had seen Blake before, on about two occasions, when his parents were doing a kid swap, but I'd never spoken to him. Blake had moved away with his dad after their parents divorced. Josh stayed with their mum. The two boys didn't spend much time together while they were growing up, which was probably a good thing for Blake. Courtney pushed her bangs aside again. They never stayed put, so I didn't know why she didn't just cut them shorter.
They're hardly estranged.
They rarely saw each other. I'd call that estranged.
Why is he crashing his brother's party? I asked.
He's lonely,
Kyle offered, making a sad face. Courtney leaned against Aaron's car.
No, he just wants to spend time with his brother. They both want to.
If Blake was like Josh, I would be coming home early for sure. I didn't even want to breathe the same air as Josh, so I sort of hoped Blake was an idiot too. Then I would have an excuse to leave that wouldn't hurt Courtney's feelings. The warm air blew my long chestnut hair in my face. I brushed the strands from my eyes, just in time to see a metallic black Mitsubishi Warrior, the only car I recognised without reading the logo, because it was Kyle's favourite subject, pull up beside me.
Here we go.
Josh was sitting in the passenger seat, and his brother was driving. They both had the same dark brown hair and blue eyes, but apart from that, they looked totally different. Josh definitely didn't inherit the looks. Blake snapped every ounce of drop-dead gorgeous and left nothing for his younger brother. Lucky for Blake. I looked away and walked around to Aaron's car, wanting to put as much distance between me and Josh as possible. Even just seeing his face made me want to punch him, especially after his demands. Courtney was smart, but when it came to him, she was as thick as a post. Josh got out of the car.
Hey guys, you remember my brother Blake?
Megan shook her head.
Nope, but hi.
Blake walked to the front of his truck and casually leaned against the hood as if he was bored.
Hey, he said with a nod.
He wore chunky black boots, dark jeans, and a black jacket, making him look mysterious and maybe a little dangerous. His dark hair stuck out in all directions in a messy style that looked like he didn't give a crap, which I assumed he didn't. His bright blue eyes scanned the group, checking us out one by one. His gaze was intense, and it was like he saw everything. I didn't want him to see anything about me.
Let's just leave already,
I said, opening the car door and climbing inside. The sooner we got there, the sooner we could get back. Damn, I sounded like my parents on Christmas Eve, when they would try to get me to sleep as the clock ticked dangerously close to midnight. But at least I would get two nights adult-free to spend with my friends. That was something to look forward to for sure.
Mackenzie, Courtney said, you're in the car with me.
My face fell. I knew what that meant.
What?
She stepped forward and leaned in the car so we could talk privately.
You're coming in the car with me, Josh and Blake.
Yeah, I'm not, I replied.
Please. Look, I know you're mad at him and I understand why, but will you try? I really think you two need to spend the car trip together to work through this.
We really don't, Court.
This weekend is going to suck if you're pissed at Josh the whole time.
I frowned. I wasn't the only one who didn't like him, though. So why was I the only one being forced to make the extra effort?
His brother's weird, I whispered, as if that was going to change Courtney's mind. Blake is harmless.
I'd run out of excuses. Sighing in defeat, I replied, All right.
but if he pisses me off by making his usual stupid comments, I'm switching cars. Courtney held up her hands.
Okay, okay. Thank you.
We're taking Blake's car then?
Yeah, they must have decided to bring Blake's instead. I can see why.
Courtney was a car person. She knew all the different types and models by sight. I couldn't even tell if something was wrong with one, unless the engine actually fell out. Blake's driving?
His car, so I guess.
She shrugged, watching Josh with a loving look that made me want to shake some sense into her.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.